So, without further ado, I am going to turn it over to all of our guests today to read you a selection from Toph Beifong's Metal Bending Academy. I'll take it away, Michaela and team.
Woohoo!
Ah.
Sounds good, everybody. Just my headband, so I'm ready to go. Right, for those following along, I am reading from my copy of the comic as well, flipping to the first page. Are we ready, Liv? Everybody? We good?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, awesome.
Let's do it.
All right. Beifong Metal Bending Academy.
Yes,
yes, you do the job.
Take your stances and metal bend.
Ha!
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 Whoosh!
Ching!
Perfect.
Oh, Sifu Toph! Sokka and Suki are at the academy entrance!
About time those two showed up.
Hello, Toph.
Finally! Took you long enough to visit.
The academy looks incredible.
Wasn't this all broken down rock tents just a few months ago? You've really upgraded this place.
Yeah. Everything is very fancy now.
That's wonderful.
With Earth and Fire Industries sponsoring the academy, I could afford to have these new facilities built. The money coming in also means I can offer metal bending training for free. And now, my students don't have to sleep on the ground.
I remember sleeping on the ground while traveling with Aang. My back still hasn't recovered.
You've accomplished so much here, Toph. It's truly amazing.
Yeah, it's pretty great.
So, is there a reason why you're acting like things are not fine? Anything we should know?
It's nothing. Everything's great. The academy's great. The students are great. Everything's just peachy.
But
I'm bored. There's no challenge anymore. The school practically runs itself. My original metal bending students, Hotan, Penga, and the Dark One, teach the beginner classes. I have scouts that search the Earth Kingdom for more metal benders. I have assistants who make sure all the bills are paid. This place is like clockwork. I do the same thing every day. Wake up, eat, teach kids metal bending, go to bed. Sure, everything's going great, but everything going great can also be boring.
And it's a good thing we're here to shake up your routine.
Yeah? Are we going on an adventure? Some new bad guy whose head needs cracking?
Even better, we're taking you to a concert.
You're what now? What's so great about this concert anyway?
Before we met you, Katara Aang and I got stuck in a cave near Omashu.
Okay.
It turned out the cave was actually a secret tunnel. There was a song about it, sung by a group of wandering musicians who were also trapped in the cave that was actually a secret tunnel.
And those same musicians went on to form the most amazing band whose music is taking the Earth Kingdom by storm. And Sokka and I have tickets to see, and Sokka and I have tickets for us to see them tonight.
You were trapped in a cave with these people, and now you're gonna pay money to hear them sing?
It wasn't my idea. Suki's crazy for their music. I'm just trying to, be supportive. She knows all of their songs by heart.
How many songs do they have?
Too many, Toph. Too many.
We got front row tickets, Toph.
You really didn't have to.
Seeing Trustfully in Love Live is a wonderful experience. I know it'll help you shake off your everyday doldrums.
I don't like this at all.
I know, buddy. I know.
Hey, I'm Chong. That's Lily, and that's Moku. And together, we're Trustfully in Love. And tonight, we want to invite all of you to trust fully in love, which is also the name of our band.
Well, this is terrible.
Oh,
Okay, this is a song I wrote about a little dude that I met a long time ago. A dude with an arrow on his head. I kind of forgot the words of the song, but the chorus goes like this.
3 hours later.
Okay, I've had enough of trusting fully in love. I'm out of here.
Top, wait, you're going to miss the interpretive dance section.
Please don't leave me!
Sorry, you're on your own. I gotta get out of here before my head explodes. Ah, barking dog. Ah, peace at last. What is that? It's earthbending, but not? This looks like it could be trouble. I'll go around the back.
Whoosh! Whoosh!
An underground bending tournament!
Two pieces on that bender. He looks strong.
I bet on a waterbender last week. He didn't pay out.
Lie down already.
You first.
This takes me back. No academy to manage, no students to train, just me and the ring. Those were the days.
Better, kid! Barrier, yeah! I got 5 gold pieces on you, kid! Make me rich!
Come on, Pipsqueak. I ain't got all day.
I have a name, you know.
I don't care about your name, kid.
You should care. My name's Sun. Remember it.
For sure.
What is that?
Hey, you're that earthbender that's with the Avatar.
I know. You're all so excited to see Toph, the greatest earthbender in...
Everybody run! The man's shutting this place down!
What? The man? I'm not the man! Hey, stop! I'm not your enemy! I just wanted to watch the fights.
The next morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Sifu Toph.
Yeah. Let's get this weekly report over with.
Well, I've been helping the beginner students get in touch with their deeper emotions.
Great. The Dark One, you're up.
I hate teaching, so I've been avoiding my students and sending them on 10-mile hikes.
Sounds good. Penga?
I?
Yep, that's great. Okay, report over. See you next week.
Sifu Toph, if you don't mind me saying so, you seem a little grumpy. More so than usual, I mean.
I've been working so hard with the beginner metalbenders. I taught them all the bending forms you taught us when we first came to the academy, and you wouldn't let me tell you about it.
I hate when Penga's emotions are the same as my own.
Is the academy in trouble, Sifu Toph? Is that why you're so upset?
No! Everything's fine. Everything's perfect. Everything's so respectable. That's the problem.
What did she mean by that?
I hate it when Sifu Toph yells at me, but I hate it even more when she's cryptic.
Is she upset because the academy is so different from how she learned bending?
Different? What would she care about that?
Sifu Toph perfected her bending skills in an underground earthbending tournament. It was a tough and difficult environment where only the strong survived. And she invented metal bending while helping the Avatar end the 100-Year War. But we get to learn metal bending at Beifong Metal Bending Academy in the lap of luxury.
The academy's hardly luxurious. I only have 2 closets for all my clothes.
And we do get yelled a lot, mostly by her.
But the academy is still a school, not a brutal bending fighting ring. It's still a place where we can learn in relative comfort. And because of the academy, we've grown so much, haven't we? Remember what we were like when we first came here?
I used to be obsessed with shoes. I couldn't go a single week without buying a brand new pair.
You're still pretty obsessed.
Not as much as I used to be. It's been a whole month since I bought a new pair.
Whatever.
At least I've changed a little. You haven't changed at all.
You still hate everything.
No, I don't. Now I tolerate things rather than hate them. Like you two, I tolerate you. I don't hate you.
Oh, the Dark One. That's so wonderful to hear. Thank you.
You're welcome, or whatever.
I've changed too. When I first came to the Academy, I saw doom everywhere. Now I hardly see doom at all.
But why is Sifu Toph mad that we've learned bending in a different way than she did? She's the one who started this school, after all.
Wouldn't it be wonderful to prove to Sifu Toph that her Academy students are just as tough and capable as she is?
We're really not, though.
You're right. We'll never be on Sifu Toph's level, but we can prove ourselves the same way she did.
This sounds scary, Hotun.
I overheard some of the new metal bending students talking about a new underground bending tournament in Yu Dao.
Underground? Like, illegal?
Yes, just like the one Sifu Toph used to compete in. And we can show her how capable we are by going toe-to-toe with the other bender fighters.
Great. Now I'm the one. Great. Now I'm the one seeing doom everywhere.
At night.
Door slowly opening.
Hey, is the bender tournament canceled?
Somebody running.
Why does everyone keep running away from me?
Rumble, rumble.
Is that a herd of saber-toothed moose lions?
Rumble, rumble.
What?
Help me! I know you. You're the tiny but powerful earthbender lady, the greatest earthbender in the world, Toph.
Toph, actually. And you're that musician, Chong, right?
I'm Chong, but I wish I wasn't. Save me, oh tiny but powerful Toph. They won't leave me alone. It's too much, man.
Okay.
Shunk!
Rumble, rumble!
Well, that was crazy. Are you hiding?
We're all hiding, powerful earthbender lady. Hiding from our true selves.
But you're literally hiding, not metaphorically hiding.
I'm not hiding by choice, powerful lady. You saw them, the fans. Their love is too strong. So I have to hide from their love. It feels so cruel, but it's for the best.
Okay, well, good luck with that. I gotta go.
Powerful earthbender lady, why are you so powerful, but also so sad?
I'm not sad. That's stupid. What would I have to be sad about? People respect me so much, they run away when they see me. Kids fighting in an underground bending tournament see me as some kind of enemy. I'm going to make the Earth Kingdom authorities magically appear and shut down everyone's fun. Don't they know I was the blind bandit? I used to be just like them. I'm proud of Beifang Metal Bending Academy, but why does my life there feel so routine? Why do I feel like my bending abilities aren't being challenged? I'm not inventing new bending techniques or saving the world. I'm just teaching bender kids how to do their stances, day after day. Meanwhile, there are kids out on the streets of Yu Dao discovering bending techniques I've never seen before. Last night, a kid did something that looked like he combined firebending and earthbending. It was amazing. That used to be me. But now I'm the bender establishment.
I get it, powerful earthbender lady. Back in the day, me, Lily, and Moku used to play our music because it was what we did, man. We were all about the love of music. But then the love became something else. It became a way to earn a living. And that can mess with the love, man. Last night, we played our music for hundreds of people in this city. It's awesome we get to touch so many hearts. But afterward, I saw this kid playing music in the street, and I wanted to be that kid. No money, no fans. All that kid had was the love of his music. Just like how it was when me, Lily, and Moku met our man Sokka. When the music you make because you love it becomes music you make because it's your job, it changes how you feel about the music, powerful Earthbender lady.
Kara, back to you.